Hello, and my name is Father Edward Przygocki. I am the Chancellor of Holy Apostles College and Seminary here in beautiful Cromwell, Connecticut. I'm also the provincial animator of the Society of the Missionaries of the Holy Apostles. I want to congratulate you on behalf of our congregation on this wonderful graduation of 2020 and 2021. We commend your accomplishments as well as your endurance during these difficult times. You know, we've always had difficult times in the life of humanity and as well as in the life of the church. But we go forward because we have a hope and a dream. The founder of our wonderful institution, Father Eusebe Menard, a simple Franciscan friar from Montreal, Canada, came here to the United States with nothing except a hope and a dream that the kingdom of God would be able to be announced from those who studied here. And now, many years later, you are fulfilling that hope and that dream. One of the great hopes and dreams in the history of salvation that was promised to our ancestors, to the people of Israel, and to all now the people of the church, was the prayer that Solomon asked the Lord. One night, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream and said, "Ask of me whatever you wish, and I will give it to you." And Solomon replied, "Lord God, you have made me a leader of your people, as young and weak that I am. But I ask you now only for an understanding heart and to know the difference between right and wrong." And the Lord was pleased with Solomon, for he had asked for wisdom. And God replied and said, "Because you have asked for wisdom in leading my people with justice, and you have not asked for a long life or wealth or the death of your enemies, I will give you what you asked for. I will give you wisdom, that you will be wise, such as no one else ever had or will ever be. Plus, I will give you what you did not ask for, riches and prosperity, and no one in the world will be compared to you for the rest of your life. And if you follow me and obey my decrees and my commands, I will give you a long life." And so, my friends, what we ask for goes beyond a long life, riches, fame, and prosperity. We ask that we be instruments of the Lord. And I'm sure each and one of you, graduates of Holy Apostles College, will be fulfilling your hope and your dream in the same way. And thus I ask God's blessing to be upon you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Again, our sincere congratulations.
Every moment you spent on your studies has been an occasion of grace to integrate reason with faith in preparation for our ultimate destination, contemplation of truth and the beatific vision of God in union with all the saints in heaven. As Saint Pope John Paul II opens his encyclical letter, Fides et Ratio, faith and reason are like two wings on which the human spirit rises to the contemplation of truth. Love of our brothers and sisters moves us to ensure that all we meet in this life we will also be reunited with to contemplate eternal truth together in heaven. For this reason, Pope Francis has encouraged Catholic colleges to participate in a new evangelization. In Evangelii Gaudium, our Holy Father beautifully writes, "Universities are outstanding environments for articulating and developing this evangelizing commitment. in an interdisciplinary and integrated way, Catholic schools, which always strive to join the work of education with the explicit proclamation of the gospel, are a most valuable resource for the evangelization of culture, even in those countries and cities where hostile situations challenge us to greater creativity in our search for suitable methods. As you go forth in the vineyard of this temporal passing world, may you keep in your minds and your hearts the ultimate reason for life, participation in Trinitarian life in communion with the saints of heaven. God bless and congratulations.
Apologist Matt Fradd is a prolific defender of the faith through his books, use of social means of communication, and public appearances. Born in Australia in 1983, Matt resides in Georgia with his wife Cameron and their children. He is an alum of Holy Apostles College and Seminary, earning his bachelor's degree in philosophy in 2015, and his master's degree in philosophy with a concentration in the history of philosophy in 2018. Both were through the online program. In line with his degree in philosophy, he published several books using his Thomistic background, one of which he co-authored with Dr. Robert Delfino. It would not be an exaggeration to say that Matt exploded onto the Catholic apologetic scene starting in 2015. He published two of his books that year, 20 Answers, Atheism, and with his wife, Restored, True Stories of Love and Trust After Porn. Never one to address easy apologetic issues, he is a major leader in helping people who struggle with the addiction to pornography. He started the Porn Effect, a nonprofit ministry that helps people break free of pornography. In addition to Restored, he wrote The Porn Myth, Exposing the Reality Behind the Fantasy of Pornography, Forged with Jason Everett, Victory, A Strategic Battle Plan for Freedom in the Struggle Against Pornography with Mark Hart, and he is the editor of Delivered, True Stories of Men and Women Who Turned from Porn to Purity. He regularly addresses this topic on podcasts, in writing, and in speaking engagements. Matt Fradd has taken on an important mission with this body of work, as pornography is a major social problem in the United States alone. For his devotion to Thomistic studies and his tireless efforts to help people addicted to pornography, Holy Apostles College and Seminary gratefully bestows the Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, on Matt Fradd. And now I introduce you to Matt Fradd.
Hello to the Holy Apostles College and Seminary community. I am honored to be speaking with you today, although I wish I was with you in person on our campus in Cromwell, Connecticut. My name is Matt Fradd, and I have recently been awarded an honorary doctorate for my work in evangelization by Holy Apostles College and Seminary. And I want to let you know how honored I am that you would trust me and award me with this, and thank you kindly. I thought today I would spend a few moments talking about evangelization and how we can do a better job at it. Now, rather than sort of delving into my own knowledge, I thought what we could do is look at the scriptures, which is always, I think, a better idea than looking at first to our own wisdom. I want to share with you one verse that I think sums up how we ought to think of evangelization and apologetics. And this verse is found in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15. Here it is here. St. Peter says, but in your hearts, honor Christ the Lord as holy, always being prepared to make a defense to anyone who asks you for a reason for the hope that's in you. Yet do it with gentleness and reverence. Absolutely love that verse. And I love it because he says, again, three things that I think we need to keep in mind as we evangelize, whether that be in person, please God, or by podcasts or videos such as this, if we have to. But again, here are the three things he says, and I've put them in different colors here just so that they'll stand out. The first thing he says is we have to honor Christ as Lord in our hearts. The second thing he says is we've got to be prepared to make a defense for our faith. And the third thing he says is to do it with gentleness and reverence. Now, that first point he makes is very important, and it's important for us all to keep in mind. Sometimes we can fall into the trap, especially if we're interacting with people who disagree with us, of thinking of the faith as an intellectual exercise, as something that's philosophically interesting. I remember when I was serving as a missionary with Net Ministries, they encourage you to spend a half hour to an hour of personal prayer a day. And I remember for a while getting really caught up in apologetics because I found apologetics fun, you know, like looking at the different verses that I could use to respond to a Protestant or something like this. And this is very sort of intellectually stimulating. But first and foremost, St. Peter says we need to love our Lord and we need to honor him as such and we need to be holy. I mean, it's holiness, I think, that at the end of the day, that really does attract people to us. You know, you don't have to be religious to recognize how beautiful people like Mother Teresa were, Benedict Rochelle, Father Benedict Rochelle, how beautiful he was. And so we have to be holy. That's the first thing that we have to do. We have to reverence Christ as Lord because we can have all the answers, but if we're not walking the walk, people aren't going to be terribly impressed. And I think at the end of the day, it's the Holy Spirit who convicts and converts hearts, not ourselves. This is something I try to remind myself of as I run my podcast, Pints with Aquinas. I suppose it's possible that I could be funny. It's even possible, I suppose, that I could be charming, though I'm not sure how much. It's possible that I can be compelling and even emotionally moving. But sitcoms can have all these elements as well. But they don't convert hearts. I want to be in the about the business of bringing people into relationship with Jesus Christ. And so I think the first thing we have to do if we're going to think about evangelizing is having our own personal relationship with Jesus Christ. The second thing, though, is also very important. We have to be prepared to make a defense to anyone who calls us for the reason, for the hope that's in you. You know, that just struck me then because I'm so used to looking at this line and talking about how important it is that we understand the faith and be able to respond to common objections to God's existence, to the person of Christ, to the reliability of the Gospels, to the claims that the Catholic Church makes for its own authority and these sorts of things, or the authority Christ gave it. And that's important, absolutely important. So we got to do that. You know, we don't all have to be walking encyclopedias. I tell you what, doing my podcast, Pints with Aquinas, I'm very often speaking with people who are far brighter than I am, who are much more apt at defending the faith. You know, so I can only do what I can do, and you can only do what you can do. But I think at the very minimum, if someone says to you, does God exist, you should be able to give them a compelling reason. If somebody says to you, how do you know that Jesus Christ was who he claimed to be, you ought to be able to give them a compelling reason. If somebody asks you why you think the Catholic Church is the church established by Christ and why it is the fullest expression of Christianity, you should be able to give them a reason. So that is important. But this struck me here. The hope that is in you. When is the last time somebody said to you, give me a reason for that hope that's in you? Do people look at you? Do they look at me and think, there's a man filled with hope? I got to be honest, lately I haven't been feeling that way. You know, we live in such a fractured, fragmented, divided world, a fractured, fragmented, divided church. I mean, just, it's difficult. It's difficult to keep hope. It's difficult to have hope. Just last Sunday, I was at Divine Liturgy and I just said to our Lord, I said, I reject cynicism. And I rejected the spirit of cynicism through the power of Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. I reject the spirit of cynicism. And in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, I proclaim that there is an inheritance for me, you know, for which I ought to be terribly joyful and optimistic and hopeful and these sorts of things. So we ought to be hopeful. In a world like this, how do you remain hopeful when you're continually being bombarded by bad news, scandalous news, outrageous news? I think be more interested in what the Word of God says than what your favorite political commentator says. Be more interested in spending time in silence than you are watching that new Netflix series. Believe me, I say that same advice to me as I do to you. Here's the third and final thing. Do it with gentleness and respect. We live in a day and age where it seems to me more and more we aren't that interested in sitting down with our ideological opponents and reasoning with them. We really just want to destroy them. And if you look at all of the YouTube videos that are out there today, such and such destroys such and such, it would seem like, yeah, we just kind of want to drop bombs on our ideological opponents. And while from a worldly point of view this is understandable, from a Christian point of view, I think it ought not to be. I think we need to be gentle and reverent with people. As I dialogue with somebody online in the comments section, if I'm talking with somebody I've just met for 5 minutes after a talk, if I'm engaging with somebody at work who I've known at a distance but we've never really gotten into it, am I aware that this person has a history? They've got parents, they've got stories from their childhood, they've got hopes and they've got dreams, they've had tragedies that have befallen them in the past. This is somebody for whom Jesus Christ died. Right? That's not just an airy-fairy sentiment. That is, if you are a Christian, an established fact. And so to be able to look at them and say, you know, here's someone who God gave his life for. You know, so I need to love them. I need to be reverent. I need to be gentle with them. I think we need to be gentle with people because I think it's fair to say that in most cases, most people don't hold on to positions that they know are in direct defiance of the truth. Maybe some people do, but I think a lot of us believe false things, but we've got reasons, inadequate reasons, for why we believe those false things. So being able to listen to each other, agreeing where we can, and then pushing them on into the fullness of the faith. So those are three things I think we all have to keep in mind. Myself first and foremost. In my heart, I need to reverence and honor Christ as the Lord. I need to be prepared to give a defense to people when they ask about the hope that I have, and I always must do it with gentleness and reverence. Thank you so much for your time. God bless you.
Good afternoon to the graduating students of Philosophy, Theology, and Pastoral Studies of 2021, and congratulations to each of you on your achievements. My name is Michael McKee, and unfortunately, I've never met any of you. I was 100% online from the very beginning, but I have grown to know some of you through Populi, through video chats, and through multiple bulletin boards, posting our different thoughts and sometimes arguing, but mostly agreeing. So thank you for all of that. My undergraduate degree is actually in the hard sciences. I'm a chemist by training. Then I went to law school, and now I'm a practicing attorney in Michigan. So you're probably wondering, how did I find myself in philosophy? Well, I started off, I just wanted to know a little bit more about St. Thomas. So I took a class, and that went pretty well. And I took another class, and that went pretty well. And then I took another class and another class, and pretty much I find myself halfway down the way to a master's degree. So I thought, why not? Let's keep going. It's at that point that I ran into Dr. Delfino, which some of you may know, and the class on metaphysics, which as a hard scientist was very strange. We talked about being, in essence, an analogy, and I'm fairly certain he pulled his hair out on more than one occasion when he was arguing with me about being, in essence, because I wasn't arguing as a philosophy student. I was arguing as a hard scientist and a cross-examining attorney, but without his help, there's no way I could have made it through it. So thank you very much, Dr. Delfino. And at that point, I said, okay, this isn't too bad. I can do this. And then I ran into Dr. Redpath and the problem of the one and the many. And I don't know if you guys know this, but it's a very difficult subject. And so now the tables were turned, and now I'm the one pulling my hair out. And I will tell you, on multiple occasions, I threw the textbook down on the desk and screamed at it as if it could hear me because I was so frustrated. I honestly didn't know what anyone was talking about, what anyone was saying, because I still wasn't really thinking like a philosopher. But Dr. Redpath ended up not only being a great professor, but also being my thesis advisor. And without his pushing and hard questions and really challenging me, there's no way I could have made it through the class, let alone the thesis. So I owe him a huge debt of gratitude. So thank you very much, Professor Redpath. Part of my thesis at Holy Apostles was talking about virtue, intellectual virtue, and all sorts of virtue. And it's not only a good habit, but it actually makes you good. And I learned that here at Holy Apostles. And I was seeing other students grow in virtue. I was seeing the professors teach that virtue. And even the staff fostering that virtue. And I know that that's a very rare quality. So thank you very much for all of that, because you set a great example. The contemporary philosopher Mortimer Adler talked about a great university not only having great professors, but also having great learners. And here at Holy Apostles, I can absolutely say that not only the professors are great, but the students are great, and you really want to learn. And that was really nice to see, because coming from hard sciences programs in various universities, that's not always the case. And it's not necessarily the case in law school, but it was different here. So thank you very much. As I'm graduating, I wish I could look out and say that the educational world is all roses, but we all know that's not true. The traditional programs in theology and philosophy are kind of an endangered species. But I'm so glad to see that not only the tradition, but the faith is strong here. And I just can't thank you enough. Throughout my studies, I learned that the scholastic tradition is not just the work of any one person in a vacuum. It's a group of people. It's thinking in the same way, pursuing the same goals, trying to reach the same results, and building on the shoulders of giants. It's transgenerational. It's historic. It's cultural. It's men and women striving together for the same goal. And I saw that in all of you. And I just pray that you guys keep doing that and taking that out to the world, because I know that that's what's most important. But it's not just limited to philosophy. It applies equally to theology and pastoral studies. As students of all of these, we need to take what we learned from the great philosophers, the saints, the spiritual writers, and distill it down and continue to pursue wisdom and to grow in the truth and spread that. That's why it's essential that you take what you learned here at Holy Apostles and go out there without doubt, without hesitation, and spread the truth. Because if not you, who's going to do it? There's no one else out there that's going to do it as well as you can do it with this type of training. So I really hope you do that. For the ancient Greeks, because I'm a philosopher, I guess now, I got to talk about the Greeks. Philosophy wasn't logic. It wasn't trivia. It was learning about the causes of things and then satisfying that cause or that wonder and coming into contact with what's true and beautiful. And that's what I hope for all of you guys to do, is to take your learning about what is true and what is beautiful and spread it to the world. Because if not you, who's going to do it? And I guess I'd be remiss if I didn't talk a little bit about Plato. He talked about, higher learning develops good citizens, and good citizens develop good politicians, and good politicians develop good cities. And your job is to use what you've learned here and try and do that. Try and be good citizens where you can. Who knows, maybe some of you will be politicians, but we can all participate in society and make it better, make our cities better, make our schools better, things like that. That's what you need to do. As for me, I wish I could tell you what I'm going to do with my degree. I don't really know. What does a hard scientist lawyer do with a philosophy degree? Well, if I had to guess, I think I'm going to try and get a PhD. There's that little voice in the back of my head that keeps saying, you need to take this to academia, because the people in my field, they don't know about St. Thomas. They don't know about genuine wisdom. They don't know about virtue. It's not just that they don't believe it. It's not even taught. It's not even introduced. So I get this real deep feeling that God wants me to take what I've learned here right into a PhD program. So I'm going to be praying about that, and I ask you to pray for me. But at the same time, and I guess most importantly, I know that God didn't put me here by accident, and I know he didn't keep pushing me down this path by accident and getting me through metaphysics and the one in the many by accident. So I'm going to trust him that he put me here for a reason, and I'm going to trust him that he's going to put me where he wants me, when he wants me, and how he wants me. That's my prayer for you guys, that you do the you have the same mentality. Let him put you where he wants you, how he wants you, and when he wants you. Thanks very much for the time, and congratulations again.
Hello and welcome. My name is Matt D'Antuono, and I want to say congratulations to all of my fellow graduates. We made it. I would also like to welcome the people in our lives who made this day possible. Family, friends, professors, staff, and administration. Thank you, on behalf of all the graduates, for all of your support, wisdom, guidance, patience, and love. It is sad that we can't be together in person today, but we are honored that we can at least be present in at least some way to celebrate this day. And of course, we have to thank those others who are present to us in their own unique way today and who have helped and guided us in a unique way throughout our education, the angels and saints of heaven. Ultimately, though, we owe all thanks to the one who is here with us in the most beautiful and intimate way, the one who sustains our very being, the true reason that we're all here today, God. He's present to us all in a very mysterious way. Figuring out exactly how he is present to us is the reason we came to Holy Apostles in the first place. Even if that's not what we were consciously thinking when we filled out the application, that desire was deep in our hearts, because the contemplation of God is the ultimate end of man, and therefore of education. The author of the book of Proverbs tells us that if we find a man with understanding, then we should visit him often, and we should allow our foot to wear out his doorstep. Thus, Holy Apostles. After learning about the different types of philosophies in my undergraduate philosophy program at a secular school, I was looking for an authentically Catholic education, because that's where my search for truth has led me. And I was so happy to find Holy Apostles. It was in the course of my classes here that I learned that the subject I teach to high school students, physics, shares a common origin with philosophy. Historically, they share a common source, but even in the very nature of the disciplines, they share a common basis, because they both begin with wonder. Man, by nature, desires to know, as Aristotle tells us. We are philosophical and scientific animals, and our capacity to wonder sets us on a journey in search of wisdom. But we do not learn alone. Our fields of study cannot be conducted by separate individuals without the input of others. We are social. We need the wise man whose doorstep we can wear out. And the wise man turns out to be a collection of many individuals. We need the community of teachers and students, as we have found here, so that we can be taught Christian wisdom. We need the books that the great minds have left for us as a way to encounter them and their wisdom. In conversation with my students, I found that the relativistic mindset, especially with regard to truth, religion, and morality, is deeply embedded in the popular worldview. A mindset that's totally inimical to wonder, because it tells us that there is no truth, and there's nothing deep and beautiful to be learned about the universe. So, I've taken the time to commit some of what I've learned to writing in the form of books, some of them written at a level where I think high school students can understand. I constantly refer back to these books and use their ideas as the basis for discussions in a philosophy club I run in my high school. Each week, I also conduct a Philosophy Friday in my physics classes, where I start class with some philosophical question or dilemma, and I try to point out the connections between science, philosophy, truth, wonder, and beauty. I pose some of these deep questions to my high school students because I want them to begin to wonder and to ask the big questions they may not otherwise ask in a world full of noise and distraction. Philosophy, as I've learned, is not just a body of information, but a habit of thought. And I try to use the habit of thought that I've learned in this program to challenge some of the ideas and unconsciously held convictions that my students have. Some of the students have told me that they are beginning to look at and think about the world in a different way. I can't say for sure that the world is worse off than it's ever been, but it is certainly in need of people who can incite wonder and point people in the right direction, as the world has always needed. We are honored by the presence of one another, and the deepest kind of presence is an encounter, a real meeting of the other, when an I meets a thou. What we find as we pursue the lines of reasoning in the presence of one another is that all roads lead to the eternal thou, the presence of an infinite God whose evidence is hidden in plain sight. This God, whose love moves the sun and other stars, turns out to be beyond our comprehension. St. Augustine wrote, "Si comprehendis, non est Deus." If you understand it, it is not God. Our search for ultimate truth begins and ends in wonder, but not in complete ignorance. St. Thomas Aquinas, you may have heard of him, tells us that even the smallest glimpse of the highest reality gives us an incomparable joy. There is no greater goal. God is the reason. God is the purpose. God or nothing can satisfy us. The contemplation of the glory of God is the reason we study and the reason we share what we have learned. Our journey to God begins in wonder and ends in wonder, and it is a community effort I am proud to have been a part of here at Holy Apostles. Thank you, congratulations, and God bless.
Holy Apostles College and Seminary, undergraduate degree recipients, class of 2021. Kelly Joseph Albers, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Letitia Ochoa Adams, Bachelor of Arts. Brother John of Jesus and Mary M. Carm Black, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Kathy L. Bonner, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Chuang T. Bui, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Anderson Bush, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Brother Paul Marie Castillo, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Larry Dale Curtis, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Derek J. Equal, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Joseph Daniel Krupp, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Brother Seraphim Mary of the Assumption M. Carm Heffernan, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Sister Chin Ho, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Sister Lean T. Ho, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Brother Jonas Houston, MSJB, Associate of Arts, cum laude. Luke Jonathan, Associate of Arts, cum laude. Nicholas Robertus Kalinowski, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Allison Elizabeth Klekas, Bachelor of Arts. Laura Ann Cobot, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Sister Mary Lewin T. Lay, Bachelor of Arts. Sister Tu Mong T. Lay, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Christopher R. Laviglio, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Angela Grace Morton, Associate of Arts, magna cum laude. Sister Mary Chin Towi T. Nguyen, Bachelor of Arts. Sister Lan Kim Nguyen, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Christopher Daniel Olson, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Martin Isaias Pantoja Lopez, Bachelor of Arts. Joseph C. Funnensteel, Bachelor of Arts. Sister Duke Hong T. Pham, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Elvira Guadalupe Mejia Romero, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Brother Kevin J. Shannon, MSJB, Associate of Arts, magna cum laude. Michael Stilson, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Philip Keith Swanson, Bachelor of Arts, magna cum laude. Christian Teole, Associate of Arts, magna cum laude. Martin H. Thompson, Bachelor of Arts. Hua Kim T. Chan, Bachelor of Arts, cum laude. Grace Marie Elizabeth Erlakis, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. James Boyd Martin Walther, Associate of Arts, summa cum laude. Grace C. York, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Elliot Joswiak, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude. Holy Apostles College and Seminary Graduate Degree Recipients, Class of 2021. Jessica Ann Andrews, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Stephen G. April, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Father John James Hampton Arcidiacino, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Gabriel Antonio Barbiate, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Adam Lawrence Barbarich, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Frank Langley Bartow IV, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Clayton Joseph Baumgartner, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Fadi Raymond Bazuzi, Master of Divinity, magna cum laude. Jeremy Russell Bohr, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Luke Jonathan Brooks, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Kimberly Marie Brown, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Father Joseph Mary Brown, CSJ, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Julie Lynn Butler, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Sunil Paul Chiriankandath, Master of Theology, magna cum laude. Paul R. Chudikorn, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Andrew Joseph Cocagni, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. James R. Colum, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Sister Jacinta Cosquilla, FSE, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Danielle Cunahan, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Jeffrey David Crook Jr., Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Matthew L. D'Antuono, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. James Russell Depfer III, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Maria DeMura, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, summa cum laude. Zap Xuyen Din, Master of Arts Theology. Chan Nak Din, Master of Divinity. Joseph M. Dos Ramos, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Patrick Michael Drexler, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Sister Alyssa Eaton, SCTJM, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Yolanda Downey Eisenstein, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. James Michael Elam, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Father Joseph Ege Essen, Master of Arts Theology. Joseph Philip Evans, Master of Arts Theology. Daniel S. Fitzpatrick, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Reed W. Fry, CO, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Abba DeWitt Fukroy, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Barry Gaunt, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Mariam Andamariam Gebreziaher, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Rachel Lynn Gehring, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, summa cum laude. Thomas J. Gentry II, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Abba Tomas Negash Gebremeskel, Master of Arts Theology. Mayari Syra Gill, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, magna cum laude. Sarah E. Gomez, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Raymond E. Gonzalez, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Matthew Todd Gray, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Barikti Kadanamariam Apti, Master of Arts in Pastoral Studies. Abba Kwasayan Hamde Ajay, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Sister Brooke Nicole Happ, SCTJM, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Timothy Mark Harris, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Cameron Hepola, Master of Arts Philosophy, cum laude. Kelly Holton, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. John Thomas Hoving, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Anna Katrina Iamarino, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Nicholas K. Iden, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Yomark Jacques, Master of Arts Theology. John Joseph Jordan, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Reverend Father Desiderius Dominic Cadabaro, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, magna cum laude. Wu Kuseng, Master of Arts Theology. Angela Mary Kus, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Zachary Krieger, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. June Lentini, Postmaster Certificate in Theology, summa cum laude. Aaron Herman Levy, Master of Arts in Theology, magna cum laude. Sister Catherine Grace Loggins, SCTJM, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Father Thomas Dominic Mambo, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Nicholas Anthony Martel, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Diane Elizabeth Matos, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Michael Edward McKee, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Daniel J. McQuillan, Master of Philosophy, cum laude. Dr. Sanayat Berhane Mesfin, Master of Arts Theology. Father Isdori Francis Magala, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, cum laude. James P. Mitchell, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Jason Michael Morgan, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Father Andrew Malele Mataki, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Father Paul Namrud, Master of Theology, magna cum laude. Justin David Newcomb, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Brother Tuong Van Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Brother Nam Van Nguyen, Master of Divinity, magna cum laude. Father Doan Van Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Mary Zon T. Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology. Sister Anna Chum Nak T. Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Sister Lan T. Nguyen, Master of Theology, summa cum laude. Sister Lin Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology. Sister Tuan Tui Han Nguyen, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Reverend Nicholas U. Nuagwu, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, cum laude. Patrick A. O'Donnell, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Sister Jean Dark Paquette, FSE, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Father Christopher Pelster, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Sister Jennifer A. Perino, SCTJM, Master of Theology, summa cum laude. Abba Johannes Germe Petros, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Sister Maria Swan T. Pham, Master of Arts Philosophy, cum laude. Reverend Andrew Tan Van Phung, Master of Theology, cum laude. Sister Mary Pham T. Phuong, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Paul Michael Holotz, Bachelor of Arts. Andrew Jared Grabe, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Christopher Michael Rawlings, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Alice Carrie Reamer, Graduate Certificate, summa cum laude. Irvin J. Reyes, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Alice Carrie Reamer, Graduate Certificate, summa cum laude. Severino S. Reyes IV, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Eric Thomas Robinson, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Melissa Mary Salisbury, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Kelly R. Sargent, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Stephen A. Sherman, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Sarah Catherine Shoup, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Kevin David Smith, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Sister Maria Fernanda Sol, SCTJM, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, cum laude. Jeannie Solis Sanchez, Master of Arts Philosophy. Patrick Steckbeck, Master of Arts Philosophy, cum laude. Lisbeth A. Stokes, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Michael Strandberg, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Deacon Jeffrey Strom, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Tewilde Mabra Tewelda, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Ryan Robert Thornton, Master of Arts Philosophy, magna cum laude. Sean Patrick Tobin, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, summa cum laude. Father Quan Tran, Master of Arts Theology. Reverend Vincent Duong Van Chan, CSC, Master of Theology, magna cum laude. John Baptiste Tutoris, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Sister Mary Lawrence Patience Ugoaru, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies. Danielle M. Van Hout, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Father Abraham Varghese, Master of Arts Theology. Reverend Tian Duc Vu, Master of Theology, summa cum laude. Sister Lu U T Vu, Master of Arts Theology, summa cum laude. Chase Laurel Wei, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Sister Mary Eleanor Welkers, SCTJM, Master of Arts in Theology, summa cum laude. Andrew Billy Wolf, Master of Arts Philosophy, summa cum laude. Edward Ellis Patrick Working, Master of Arts Theology, cum laude. Abba Sigai Solomon Sir Mikhail, Master of Arts Theology, magna cum laude. Richard Allen Zupan, Master of Arts Pastoral Studies, cum laude.